Here's how to edit a video easily using completely free software. We're going back to the basics. First up, let's make a folder for the project. Mine's called River, and you'll see why in a second. Now, we've already filmed, so we can take this card from the camera and this USB card reader and connect them up. So we're going to find the video clips, select them all, and copy them into our project folder. Once that's done, we may as well take out the SD card. Now, since we're going for simple and free software, I'm going to find Windows Movie Maker. It is free, you just might have to download it. And if you're using a Mac, you can use iMovie, which is basically very similar. Either way, before we can start editing, we need to import the footage, which basically means dragging it and dropping it into the software. And now we wait. This part can take a while. When it is finished processing, we now have all of our footage laid out one after another in the timeline, and we can start editing. Watching the first clip, it's hardly surprising that there's a bit at the beginning that we don't really need to see. So let's find where we actually want it to start and click Set Start Point. Now it's hidden that first bit and we can watch it through until we feel like we've seen enough, and then we click Set End Point and it will move on to the next shot. And really, that is what most of editing is, deciding when to come in and when to move on. No matter how expensive the software is, we'll spend plenty of time working out how long each shot should last. But for a video as simple as this, the general idea is just to remove the boring parts. If the whole clip is useless, we can right-click and remove it, or just hit the delete key. But what if we like the start and the end of the clip, but we want to remove the middle? For that, we can use the split tool to separate it into three separate clips, and then just delete the second one so it skips out that middle section entirely. By the time we've removed everything we don't want, the video is almost always much shorter than what we started with, and that's totally normal. Once we've cut down each shot, we should then watch the whole thing through to see if any parts feel too slow, or if we've removed too much and it's not actually making any sense anymore. Of course, the other big part of editing is the order. We can try clicking and dragging a clip to put it earlier or later in the video, and that can get us thinking about what we want to show people first and what we can save for a strong and memorable ending. If we feel the need to add some text, then we can click Home, then add a caption, and from here it's just like using a text box in any other software. Change the font, change the size, move it around. The title will also show up on the timeline so we can move it around or change the duration, just like the video clips. Now, sound is very easy to forget about, but that would be a big mistake. So with simple software like this, I'd just recommend going and finding a song or a movie trailer on YouTube and use that to adjust the volume of your speakers until they sound about right. Now when we go back to our project, we might notice that it's too quiet or that it was much louder than the music, and we can change the volume of each clip individually. If we want to use some background music, then we can go to Add Music and find some that we've made or downloaded earlier. After that, it's the same old story. We choose when we want the music to come in, when we want it to stop, and adjust the volume if needed. So we've covered the essentials, but then we see the visual effects panel. That sounds pretty fancy, that sounds pretty Hollywood, but no, they're mostly just cheesy filters that most professionals would stay well away from. So there we go. Once we're happy with the duration and the order of each shot, and we've included any sound, music, or titles that we needed, we can then export or save the video, putting it into our project folder with the rest of the files. As soon as that's done, we'll be able to put our edited video straight onto YouTube, or I don't know, burn it onto a DVD, whatever you want. Hopefully though, this served as a short, simple introduction to editing. My name's Simon Cade, this has been DSLR Guide, and I'll see you next week.